بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
Inspire 2015.
Do you know that one of the core purposes of your existence is for you to be grateful? Na'am. Allah says in the Quran,
وَاللَّهُ أَخْرَجَكُمْ مِنْ بُطُونِ أُمَّهَاتِكُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ شَيْئًا وَجَعْلَ لَكُمُ السَّمْعَ وَالْأَبْصَارَ وَالْأَفْئِدَةَ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَشْكُرُونَ.
Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created you and you did not know anything. And Allah given you sight, given you hearing, and given you hearts. Why? So perhaps you may be grateful. May Allah make you all among those who are grateful. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Brothers and sisters, are you grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? You have to continuously ask that question. You know, for the ability to see, the fact that you can see me, you appreciate that or you got used to it? Yes, we got used to it. But sometimes you have to sit down with kuru ni'matallahi alaykum and just think of Allah's blessings upon you. Are you grateful that you can hear me? I have a relative of mine, a cousin of mine. One time we were sitting and then she saw us laughing and she was crying. Why? Because she cannot understand what we're saying because my cousin is deaf. Did you appreciate that? Something to truly ponder upon. True story, I'm telling you this second person, one of my own teachers. He was invited to a multimillionaire who had 600, I'm aware of the number, $600 million in cash. I'm not saying buildings, apartments. No, in cash, 2.5 billion ringgits, if I calculate the currency correctly. Okay, depending on the day. So every lecture, I have to change the number depending on the society. Okay? So this man with that much wealth, he had two children, a boy who left him to go to the Gulf to begin his own career. You have people like that. I want to build my own future and things like that. His daughter married another man, so he was alone with his wife. As they were driving, they got into a car accident. This man's wife passed away on that scene. May Allah grant her Jannah. And grant Jannah to all those who passed away amongst us. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Then this man was completely paralyzed. Cannot move a single muscle. Then what happened? The driver remained alive. As if Allah purposely has done that in order for the driver to serve the one who is paralyzed. So the sheikh was invited over because the rich man wants to talk to him, just express things to him. He said, you see this bed right beside me? No, the man speaking is paralyzed on the bed. You see the other bed? This is the bed of the driver. He sits by me to serve me. He said to the sheikh, I swear by Allah, there are nights that come that I just want to itch my back, but he cannot do it. So I would tell the driver, please, if you can assist me with that. But there are nights where I have requested that request so many times, I feel bad for him every time I would wake him up. So there are nights that come, I want to itch my back and I cannot do it and I feel bad to wake him up. So I say out loud to myself, who would take $600 million in cash for one hand? Who would take $600 million in cash for one hand? You are all millionaires, but many of you perhaps never noticed that. Say alhamdulillah. And you see when you recognize the blessing, how perhaps your alhamdulillah comes more from the heart. And that's a practice that you should be doing. Allah says, وَذْكُرُوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ عَلَيْكُمْ. Continuously recognize Allah's blessings upon you. And this is the sense that you will get. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also wants you to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala verbally. When you're done with eating your food, say alhamdulillah. When something difficult happens to you, something that you see which you do not like, the Prophet's attitude, you know what he used to say? He used to say, Alhamdulillahi ala kulli hal. Can we, inshallah, adopt this action item, inshallah? Anytime you see something, someone double parked you, you go for Jum'ah prayer, someone blocks you, right? You're like, Alhamdulillah ala kulli hal, right? You're like, wow, mashallah, you're very righteous. Are you single? Right? They're like, subhanAllah. The point being is that you try to have that attitude. Allah will bless you. Alhamdulillah tamla al-mizan. We'll fill up the mizan for you. May Allah make your mizan yawm al-qiyamah heavy. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. فَأَمَّا مَنْ ثَقُلَتْ مَوَازِينُ فَهُوَ في عيشة راضية. May Allah grant it to all of you. Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. He appreciated that. When the Prophet saw something that he likes, he also said what? Alhamdulillah. But then he said, Alhamdulillah, الذي بنعمته تتم الصالحات. That the one by his blessings, good things happen. Allah, look how he attributes it to Allah. May Allah make us grateful, Ameen, Rabbil Alameen. Physically is the top notch. May Allah make us reach that level. Physically is where you do the obligatory acts, and that's the number one thing which Allah loves. Allah said this authentic hadith, Qudusi. The most beloved thing Allah loves from us and that gets you close to Allah is when you do the obligatory acts. If you're truly grateful to Allah for your ears, you will do your best not to be involved in backbiting. Wallahi, if you have this concept of gratitude, gratitude becomes the pillar for you to stop sinning. Isn't that right? Out of shame. If you remember the story of Yusuf alayhi salam, when the lady ghalaqat al-abwab, correct, she locked all the doors, she said, hayta lak, I'm all yours, and Yusuf alayhi salam was there. What did he do? He says, innahu rabbi, huh, continue, ahsana mathwai. He said, my Lord has blessed me. How can I do that? Gratitude was what helped him. You guys paying attention? Gratitude was what made him patient. Is that he recognized Allah's blessings upon him. He's like, how can I use my beauty in such fashion? Allahu Akbar. May Allah make us like Yusuf alayhi salam, Amir Rabbil Alameen. In handsomeness as well. May Allah make you as handsome as Yusuf, like both patient and grateful. Ameen Rabbil Alameen. Something to truly appreciate. Another thing that you can do physically, there's something from the sunnah that is called sajdat al-shukr. You guys know that? Which literally speaking, you hear some amazing news. For example, one time I was taking a course called heat transfer. That's a mechanical engineering third year. And I was looking at the final grades and I got an A+. So, wallahi, out of, and sometimes you get so happy, you don't know what you're doing, right? So I saw a guy beside me, I kissed him. He's like, what are you doing? Then I'm like, oh, sajdat shukr. And I went down. And that's a way to be grateful to Allah. Just randomly drop on the floor and make sajdat shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ulama, they said, you don't have to have wudu. You don't have to face the qibla. You can just drop there. You don't have to like, oh, where the hijab? No, no, just drop there and make sajda to Allah, and thank Allah for the blessings, and feel free to make dua besides that gratefulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Can we inshallah do that? You know, one time when I learned this, I was a lot younger, yeah. So I used to love a football team. So when they got a penalty kick, I went down, sajda shukr. I'm like, is that why you use that sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Use it, why not? Penalty kick, goal, bismillah, go sajda shukr. Well, how beautiful is it when you see a player going down in sajda? Isn't it nice? SubhanAllah, may Allah make us humble, Ameer Rabbil Alameen, and practice the deen the way Allah wants us to practice it.